What's going on, guys? K-Pine here, and welcome back. And in this video, I'll be showcasing some battles featuring Shadow Venusaur in the Open Great League. Not gonna keep the intro nice and short, because we all know already that Shadow Venusaur hits like an absolute truck, and oh boy, did it send some opponents running. And with that, let's get into the battles. Alright, getting to the first battle, we lead Shadow Venusaur into Azumarill. You absolutely love to see it. They're gonna swap into that Sableye, we're gonna meet it with our Umbreon, and that, my friends, is the first top left of the video. GG's. Next battle, Shadow Venusaur into Shadow Nidoking. What a spicy pick. Absolutely love to see that from my opponent. But look at that. Those poison jabs are absolutely chunking. And my opponent makes a fantastic catch of this frenzy plant onto their Shadow Dragonite. But look at that. That Shadow Frenzy Plant did half the Dragonite's HP. We bring in the Walrein, we farm down, and we get another top left. GG's. Next battle, Shadow Venusaur into the mirror. This is a little tricky because it is a bait game, whether you're gonna land the Frenzy Plant or the Sludge Bomb to shield or not, but I'm feeling a little risky. I'm gonna call the Frenzy Plant and I'm going straight for the Sludge Bomb myself. They do go for the Frenzy Plant. That's a fantastic call on our end. Now we're going for the Sludge Bomb. Do they wanna give up a shield or are they gonna call it back? They don't want to. They're gonna switch in their Noctowl, Simul Swap on the Shadow Walrein, and that is the third top left in just as many games. GG's. Next battle, Shadow Venusaur into Registeel. And you may think that this is a bad matchup for the Shadow Venusaur, but it's really not. Shadow Venusaur has a good matchup here because, again, it just hits so hard and it can take a move from the Regi. That is a resisted Frenzy Plant, my friends. Registeel's almost already down to half health. Now, the reason why I say this isn't a bad matchup for us is because even though we do lose the zero shield, so we will have to give up a shield of our own, Venusaur wins the one shield scenario and the two shield scenario. So we can play this out in our favor. As right here, I will shield up the Focus Blast, farm up to back-to-back Frenzy Plants, where hopefully we will be able to get them both off before a move from the Registeel comes through, but it's a CMP tie. Pretty unfortunate for us, so we do want to keep switch advantage. So I will shield that Focus Blast and go for the farm down, which I'm able to do, surviving on 1 HP. And now I'm going to store all this energy, switch into my Walrein, and they have a Sableye, which is great because if they stay in, I'm gonna be able to pressure their last shield, and if they swap out, I get my Umbreon aligned to this Sableye in the end game. Very nice counting by my opponent. They play to the CMP tie. And if they go straight for the return, which they do, very nice play. They get to hold on to their shield. But this is still somewhat of a fine situation for me because I get to bring in my Umbreon and go for a farm down, and they have Frostlass. So now, this is very, very doable. I just need to make sure I'm throwing with proper timing so I don't let any free powder snows go through. And Umbreon, extremely, extremely tanky, will be able to take two avalanches. The second avalanche coming through right here. We take that like an absolute champ, throw one more Snarl for good timing. This will be getting the first shield from the Frostlass, and I could combo play right there, but I don't want to risk a turn lag and then not getting the move off. So instead, I'm just going to throw this foul play against the Frostlass. And we reach another foul play to take out the Umbreon. If we didn't, Shadow Venusaur should win the CMP tie against the Sableye, unless it's extremely attack weighted. But that one looked more defensively weighted to me. And we're able to take this matchup. GG's to my opponent. The fifth match of the set. Yeah, these battles went by quick. Noctowl, absolutely terrible lead. We know what we're doing. We're swapping into the Umbreon, where hopefully we can get our Walrein aligned to the Noctowl, but they swap into a Metacham. And this is looking like a hard counter game so far. We're gonna throw off this foul play. If this is an Ice Punch Psychic Medi, it's a little better for us because, as you'll see, as long as the Metacham isn't extremely bulky, like a level 50 XL, level 50 XL Metacham can throw an Ice Punch and then counter all the way down. while tanking 3 foul plays. If it's not, it can only tank 2 and the third threatens the KO, which my opponent right here seems like theirs isn't a fully maxed out Medicham because they do give up that shield. And that's great because now we get shield advantage. I will have to give up a shield right here to this Ice Punch because that will do a lot. And I'm going to go for the farm down. Hopefully I get it in time, but they don't. Remember, the Ice Punch counts on Medicham are 6, 6, 6, 5. So really what I should have done was swapped out to catch that Ice Punch on the Walrein. And that way I would have been able to save my shield where hopefully I could sweep in the back. Because they do have a Registeel and shields down, I have no chance in this matchup. So I'm going to go for an Icicle Spear bait, see what happens. My opponent calls it. So now this game is absolutely over. They're going to be able to land the Focus Blast. Down goes Walrein. In comes Venusaur. And just to save a little time, even though the match was long over by then, we're going to top left and pick up a nice little 4-1. Next match. We lead Shadow Venusaur into Azumarill. Please show me the Sableye. Please show me this. There's the Sableye. We swap in the Sableye. And my opponent this time is staying in, potentially making a play for switch, but I have a high ranked Umbreon. The Sableye doesn't reach the Shadow Claw breakpoint against us, so 2 returns will not quite threaten a KO, which means if my opponent gives up a shield, we do give up a shield as well. If they don't, we don't either. We force them to be the first ones to shield. And my opponent makes a nice play here, throwing on the CMP tie to my next foul play. Really, I should have just snarled down all the way to have all this energy for the Azumarill, but that's okay because we have our Shadow Venusaur waiting for it, which is gonna absolutely tear it to shreds with the Frenzy Plant. We do get this Last Resort off for a little bit of extra chip damage. That's always nice. Unfortunately, the Azumarill does get a farm down, so they are going to be able to reach an ice beam right here and force one of my shields, but Hydro Pump. So apparently they're running Hydro Pump play rough. My opponent swaps into Altaria, classic Azu Altaria core, and we just RPS that match. GG's. What is that? Like the 4th top left of the video so far? I'm telling you, my opponents, they were scared of the Shadow Venusaur. Pelipper, pretty bad lead for us, so we're going to swap into our Walrein, which can hit for those neutral Icicle Spears, and in comes Registeel. I baited last time, they called it, I'm not going to bait this time, I'm going to full send it, and well, they shield, so it would have been a nice scenario to bait right there, but that is perfectly fine. We do get ourselves a shield advantage. And you know what, I'm feeling a little risky, so I'm going to actually shield that Zapkin, and unfortunately they do get the debuff. So now this Earthquake won't threaten to KO, and they can let it go through, which they do. But now, since they let it through, I can make a play for switch. I can get to the back-to-back Icicle Spears, which will threaten to KO this Registeel. And instead of shielding it, which would have been the wrong play, let it go, which is the right play. But now, because I do get shield advantage, I can align my Umbreon to the Pelipper and my Shadow Venusaur to the Gfisk, which is exactly where I want it, away from the Pelipper, because those super effective wing attacks will chunk. So I bring my Venusaur right here. They throw right before I get to the Frenzy Plant. Nice counting by them. Earthquake will hit hard, but it's just not enough to take us out. I will overfarm, see if I'm able to get to the back-to-back Frenzy Plants so I can throw one at the Pelipper, but I'm not able to. Plus they shield. So now we're gonna save our Shadow Venusaur for potential Sack Swap, or maybe, who knows, a Vine Whip could do some big damage at the end. But my opponent does get an Earthquake's worth of chip first before bringing in the Pelipper. And I'm going to go for the Last Resort right here, hoping, because Last Resort does a little more damage than Foul Play, and I was only going to get to one move. So I was hoping that Last Resort plus an extra Snarl will be enough to take out the Pelipper. It is just not. And unfortunately, we are going to go down right here to this Weather Ball. For now, our Venusaur Simul takes out the Pelipper, but they still have the Gefisk alive in the back. My opponent played that one very, very well. Good game to him. Next matchup. Shadow Venusaur into Shadow Swampert. The dream lead. You absolutely love to see it. They swap into a Trevenant. We have our hard counter out answer in the Umbreon, and this is looking like another RPS matchup for us. Seabomb comes through, not worried about that at all. Gonna throw three more Snarls and then the foul play for good timing, not allowing any extra turns to this Trevenant. Foul play lands, and now we're just gonna Snarl on down and leave with close to the back-to-back foul plays, which we do. See what they want to come in with, if they want to bring back in the Shadow Swampert or show their third. They show their third and it's Bastiodon. So Shadow Venusaur is going to have to do a lot of work this game. And basically, I'm going to use my Walrein as somewhat of a damage sponge, but it can still put in work against this lion as well, with the Icicle Spears to threaten the Shadow Swampert and the Earthquake to threaten the Bastiodon. We do get to another foul play right there. We'll be able to reach one before I get taken out. No, we fall just short, but that's perfectly fine, because like I said, we have our Shadow Walrein with the Icicle Spears for the Swampert. Throw this right now, take one of their shields. And I'm going to save both my shields for Shadow Venusaur, because like I said, it can handle the Bastiodon. It can obviously handle the Swampert. So call Hydro Cannon. They're forced to throw their second one right here, which is perfectly fine, because now this sets up Shadow Venusaur for the perfect farm down on the Shadow Swampert. We throw one more Vine Whip. We don't want them to get any extra energy with a free Smackdown. And since we do have two shields right here, all we need to do is shield up this Flamethrower, load up on energy, throw on good timing, but my opponent throws another move right here. One Vine Whip, then the Frenzy Plant. And look how much that does. Shadow Venusaur taking out a Bastiodon from that health range with the Frenzy Plant. It just hits so hard. GG's to my opponent. Next matchup, Shadow Venusaur into Noctowl. Again, terrible lead for us. So we're going to swap into our Umbreon, and we see that Medicham again. Unfortunately for us, we throw on bad timing there. It's always hard to gauge on the swap in when you're misaligned to throw on good timing or not. We let a free counter through. But that is okay, because we do bait out the Medicham, so our Walrein doesn't have to see it. Next foul play coming through. Nice chip damage to the Medicham. And it looks like that this Medicham is more XL'd than the previous one we saw before. So they will not have to give up a shield, which is a little bit unfortunate for us, but that is okay. See, they take that foul play. Now we can bring in our Venusaur farm down. Now we're going to swap immediately into our Walrein, expecting them to come with the Noctowl, which they do, and they stay in. Are they ABA weak to the Shadow Walrein? Which seems absolutely crazy to me, because yeah, even though Walrein got pushed out of the meta with its Icicle Spear nerf, it's still somewhat relevant, especially with all the Noctowls and Pelippers and Flyers and Altarias that you see everywhere. And it turns out that they are with the Diggersby. So now this is Walrein's game. Walrein's going to constantly overfarm, stay at the most energy it can. I'm going to let this go. Feeling a little risky. And it is just a Fire Punch, which is great for us. So we can let that one go. Now we are going to have to shield the second Fire Punch. We're going to load up until 1-4. I don't throw on the CMP tie right there. I throw 1-4 the CMP tie, just in case they do decide to shield the move. Then a Fire Punch would take us out if I was to throw on the CMP tie, and I lose an entire Icicle Spear. But by throwing 1-4, that means if they shield, we'd throw another Icicle Spear on the CMP tie again, and that's a waste for the shield. So good call by my opponent, but we are also counting the Noctowl's moves, able to catch the Winged Sky attack on the Shadow Venusaur, which does an absolute chunk to us. They farm down. We're able to get to another Icicle Spear before they get to another wing attack, and we take the game. GG's. Next battle. Shadow Venusaur into Azumarill. Show me that Sableye. Show me that Sableye. There's a Sableye. We bring in our Umbreon, and let me say, if you're tired of the Azumarill, Sableye, Altaria cores facing those all the time, run this team. You'll never lose to that team again. I can tell you that much. It's hard counter city. One more Snarl, four, then a foul play. Good timing. Same thing again here. And my opponent gives up a shield, so they're looking to make a play for switch. But unfortunately for them, because they gave up a shield, we are going to as well, because we absolutely want to maintain that alignment at all cost. This is most likely a foul play bait, but it ends up not being, and that's great for us because we were planning on shielding anyways. So now we get to throw off this foul play, get their last shield, or take out the Sableye. Excuse me, they didn't have any more shields because we already got their last shield. And now this scenario just went from great to even better for us. If you're questioning or wondering how that was even possible, because we come out of that with a shield advantage too. And it looks like this Azumarill is going for the bubble down, wanting to get back-to-back ice beams for the Shadow Venusaur, one to threaten the shield and one to threaten the KO. And they are able to get that bubble down, but that is okay. We will shield up because we have to. Here comes that Altaria, in comes our Walrein, and because we're fast enough on the swap, we're able to get to this Icicle Spear before they reach a Sky Attack, which takes out the Altaria, and now all we need to do is reach an Earthquake, and that should be able to handle the Azumarill. Not before a Play Rough comes through. Will it be enough to take out the Walrein? It is not. We're going to throw this Earthquake as soon as we get it. No need for good timing here, because this will be enough to take out the Azumarill, which it is. GG's to my opponent. And yeah, another 4-1 with the team. A nice quick one in today's video. Just wanted to showcase the absolute power that Shadow Venusaur has and the fear it could instill in opponents, especially when you run it in this line. Just some nice fun battles overall. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate you. If you enjoyed it, please drop a like, subscribe, and comment down below. I'd love to hear what you have to say. And with that, I'll catch you in the next one.